All right, we're back with example four. We're going to be looking at an engineering application. It says the diagonal bars across a gate give it its support. Since the angle measures and the lengths of the corresponding sides are the same, the triangles are congruent. So given that PR and QT bisect each other, angle PQS is congruent to angle RTS, and side length QP is congruent to side length RT, we need to prove that the triangles QPS, I'm just going to draw. So this triangle here, okay, this one in here, and TRS, we need to show that these two triangles inside here are congruent to each other. There's just four triangles, so I'm trying to differentiate. So, okay, so this is, we need these two to be congruent. Okay, so let's start looking at it. Remember, to prove that those triangles are congruent, we need how many pieces of information? You guessed it, six pieces of information, three angles, and three sides. So I'm just going to write this on the side to help me just track where I am in the problem so I know what I need to look for. Okay, so let's break down this first bit here. It says PR and QT bisect each other. So if PR and QT bisect each other, what we know, if PR bisects QT, then we know that this side and this side are congruent. And if QT bisects PR, then we know it cuts it in half, right? And if it cuts it in half, it means that those two are the same. So let's just go ahead and write down that first given information. PR, line segment PR, and QT bisect each other. Okay, so that's given. And then from that, we really have those two pieces of information. So we can say line segment QS is congruent to line segment ST. And we can also say that PS is congruent to SR because of the definition of a bisector. Okay. All right, so what do we have here? We have two sets of sides. That's nice. That was a great piece of information. That was kind of clutch. So now we have two sides, all right? So we have two out of the six. Let's go ahead and move on to the next piece of information that just says angle PQS. So this one here is congruent to RTS, this angle here. Pretty straightforward. Angle PQS is congruent to angle RTS. Okay, that's just given. And that's nice, that's an angle, right? That's our first angle. So we have two sides and one angle. Okay, what about the next one here? Let's look, what's the next piece? Just right here, QP is congruent to RT. So line segment QP is congruent to line segment RT. QP, RT, okay, so those are congruent, so I'm gonna have to give it three hash marks. And those are all the sides, right? So now we have all the sides, which is wonderful. Now we just need to find those last two angles, and it's just nice that it's written right here and I can track it. But we're out of given information. So how are we gonna see that, okay? We're trying to prove those two triangles. There's nothing else. It's kind of like we have to just lean on all of the information that we ever learned in this class. What do you see? What do you see? Do you see that we have another set of vertical angles? So we know that these two angles are congruent to each other because of the vertical angles theorem. So we can say that angle Q RSP is congruent to angle RST because of the, oops, I didn't write that, that's given. Because of the vertical angles theorem. Okay, so that's another angle. Now we have two angles. All we're doing is we're missing that third angle. How on earth are we ever going to determine that this third angle right here and right here are congruent to each other? How is that ever going to happen? And if you're thinking, oh, we already have two sets of corresponding angles, therefore the third angle is always congruent because of the third angles theorem, you would be correct. So angle QPS is congruent to angle SRT, SRT, because of the third angles theorem. And that is our last angle, right? So now we have all six pieces of information. Since we have all six, we have three sets of sides and three sets of angles. We know that these triangles are congruent. So we can say triangle QPS is congruent to triangle TRS because of the definition of congruent triangles. Woohoo, we did it. All right, awesome job. Let's go on and look at the last problem. Check it out, example four. All right. We're going to try this one together. So what do we have? It says, given MK bisects JL and JL bisects MK, and JK is congruent to ML, and JK is parallel to ML. I wonder why they give us that piece of information. How interesting. We need to prove that JKN, okay, so this triangle right here is congruent to LMN, which would be this triangle right here. Okay, we need to show that those two triangles are congruent. So let's just start breaking it down. So the first bit we have is that MK bisects JL. So if MK bisects JL, right, that means that these two are going to be congruent. So let's just go ahead and write that down. So MK, line segment MK bisects line segment JL. That is, what is that? Given. And if it does that, then we know that JN is congruent to NL, line segment NL, because of the definition of a bisector. Oh, I forgot to write my six pieces of information. Six pieces, that's what we need. We need one angle, two angle, three angle, and then what do we need? Four sides, sets of corresponding, three sets of corresponding sides. So side, side, side. All right, so what do we have? We have one side, okay? One side here, so that's a side. Okay, so that's our first. Only need five more pieces of information. We can do it. Okay, let's move on to the next one. It says JL bisects MK. So that means that that cuts this segment in half, which means if it cuts in half, these two are congruent. So I'm just going to write that information down. JL bisects MK. That's given. And we know that MN, line segment MN, is congruent to line segment NK because of a definition of a bisector. Perfect. So that's our second side. All right. What do we have? Okay, we use that. Okay, now we're here. JK is congruent to ML. JK is congruent to ML. Okay, that's JK congruent. That's just really straightforward. Okay, JK is congruent to ML. Nice. just super easy. Oh, that means we have all three sides. Nice. And what is that? That's just given, right? Okay. Now we have this bit here. JK is parallel to ML. JK is parallel to ML. So we have all three sides, so we're done with the sides. So what do we know? We know that this is parallel, right? Now we need to find the angles, the three angles. Why would they tell us that these are parallel? They would tell us that these are parallel because they want us to think about these being two parallel lines, right? And if we extended this, and then we extended this here, what would we have? It would be like, this is a parallel line, this is a parallel line, and this is that transversal, which would mean by the alternate interior angles theorem, these two angles would be congruent. Woohoo! So we have line segment JK is parallel to line segment ML. So you have, that's given, right? So know that whenever they do that, it's like opening up that treasure box of the alternate interior angles, the alternate exterior angles. We have the, what other was there? There was the same side interior angles and the corresponding angles postulate. So whenever you see that two lines are parallel and we have a transversal there, you just need to be like, oh, that's wanting me to unlock that information. So here we go. We know that JKL in that angle, angle JKN is congruent to NML, angle NML, because of the alternate interior angles theorem. Okay, so we have our first angle. Woohoo! Okay, that's it. That's our first angle. We need two more angles. So what do you see? What do you see? What do you see? We're out of given information, so now we just have to kind of look at this and just think back on of all of our knowledge, and is there anything we see? Do you see it? Do you see it? We're trying. We need two more angles. Do you see that we have vertical angles here? So that means that these two angles are congruent. So we know that angle JNK is congruent to angle MNL because of vertical angles theorem. Okay, that's another angle. So we have all three sides. Ah, we have two angles. We're just missing that third angle. However on earth are we ever going to determine what that third angle is? And if you're thinking, oh, it's the third angles theorem, you would be correct. Whenever you have two sets of angles that are congruent, you know that that third angle is also going to be congruent. So we're going to say that angle, this angle here, right, KJN, angle KJN is congruent, okay, KJN is congruent to MLN, angle MLN because of the third angles theorem. Woohoo, we did it! We found all three angles and all three sides. We know that we have six pieces of information. Now we can say that these two triangles are congruent. Before we do that, can you guys think of another way that we could show that these two angles are congruent? Well, what about if we have these two parallel lines and then we made this our transversal? Do you see how these two angles would be congruent by the alternate interior angles as well? Just wanted to point that out so that you saw that as well. Okay, but we are going to state that these triangles are congruent. JKN is congruent to triangle LMN because of the definition of congruent angle triangles, not triangles. Definition of congruent triangles. Perfect. So remember, whenever you're solving problems and it asks you to find these two triangles and prove that they're congruent, you need to show for this section all six pieces of information. Three sets of corresponding angles and three sets of corresponding sides. So that's it for this lesson. I will see you in a little bit for the next lesson. All right, bye. Have a wonderful rest of the day.